this answer.
Right. Greetings from the Special Ops Bible Club in the game. So, as we listen to you today, we have Jaime who's come to be baptized. And then also our brother Steve in the West. So God has been moving in his life, being disciples not only around him, but also in his workplace. So I'm going to let Abram share with you quick.
Come on, bro. Come on, Abram.
Good morning, sir. This is amazing, by the way. My name is Abram. I do have the honor and privilege to be here in Southland, just even going to Chicago. Grateful. I just want to share just a little bit about Jaime. Jaime is an amazing guy. He has a great heart for God. He really loves people.
Yeah.
And he's always this is his thing. He's like, Abram, slow down. Abram, relax. you know when somebody can get to you and just kind of like you really feel it. But I totally believe that God really put me in his life so I can learn something from this individual. He's a very young man, sharp, diligent. Consistence.
Come on, bro.
I mean, you have to talk about that. I'm grateful I met you, you know, in my daughter's house. You were there when I really needed somebody. And God knows, God made everything clear for me, man. And I think, you know, you were amongst so many people in the field, but you were like so many people, you know. And I knew it was like, man, you know, when you talk to somebody, they're like, man, this guy's a disciple, but they don't know it.
Right.
And Jaime is that person, and he's going to get baptized today. And I just want to share that. You guys want to share a picture with John 8. It says, if you hold to my teaching, then you are really my disciple. Then you know the truth. And the truth is the truth. I can't wait to find you, my brother. I love you with all my heart, man.
If I think of one word, when I think about Jaime, it would be integrity.
Wow.
Jaime came in very much so like, I'm not doing this for anybody but me.
That's right.
And so it was like, all right, we have the foundation set there. And he was just like, I'm not into the pushy thing. You're not going to make me do anything I don't want to do. But as we studied, it was every time it was like, okay, so what do you think about this, Jaime? What are you getting from? He's just like, I get it. You know, yeah, no, I'm not a disciple. I need God. And just talking to he just was like, you know, I'm here because I'm tired. You know, I'm just worn out. I've been doing it. I'm surprised I made it this far by myself. And, I'm just really tired. And I just want to share a quick scripture because this is definitely what reminded me of you. Philippians 3:8 says, what is more, I consider everything a loss because of the surpassing worth of knowing Christ Jesus my Lord. For whose sake I have lost all things, I consider them garbage that I may gain Christ.
Wow.
And then later on the scripture says, I want to know Christ. And that was Jaime's heart. He's just like, I don't want anything, I just want to know God. So right now I'm going to let Jaime share with you.
Come on, Jaime.
Honestly, I really do not know what to say. I think I will just basically summed it up. I have been tired for like a long time. I remember March was actually my breaking point. Everything just basically started collapsing. And I just remember that I would just start praying and I just was asking that I know I need to get right. I was once a part of a church, like about when I was little, like 10 years ago. I was like Catholic and part Christian at one point. And going through the things I went through, I basically turned my way away from the church because I felt these churches I went to they didn't preach love or anything. They were more about hate. Mm-hmm. And they pick and choose who they wanted in it.
Come on, bro.
So to me, it was just more the time that I needed guidance, I needed help. You know, it wasn't there, so I took it as a sign that, you know, God ran away from me. So I basically did the same thing in return. not gonna lie, I did. I lived in darkness for until now.
Hey, man. Hey, there you get it. He gets it. That's good. He gets it. You know what I'm saying? Funny.
A part of me is gonna really say that I did enjoy it. You know, it's survival of the fittest, basically. Mm-hmm. But a part of me always, regardless how much I try to turn away, is like a part of me always picked over my shoulder and just try to. I would pray here and there. I mean, I try to like let go and I couldn't let go. And so finally, right now, I just knew I had to come back. And just, like, God answered my prayers.
So I have two most important questions in your life. Do you believe that Jesus was the Son of God that came to earth, lived a sinless life, was crucified and died for your sins, and rose on the third day?
Yes.
What is your great confession?
Jesus is Lord. Thank you.
Spirit, you will be forgiven for sins, past, present, and future, and be added to God's kingdom.
See you later.
Ooh, yeah, I'm later.
Okay. So you're gonna. Okay.
Turn around. Turn around.
You're gonna
picture
a little bit. You're gonna cross your hands and you're gonna grab your nose with your there you go. Yeah, like that.
Picture.
Pull it back.
I'm in.
Get down.
Oh, okay. We're taking a picture. Sorry.
Oh. Abram's just smiling.
There you go. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay. So crossing. Hold your nose. Bend down a little bit. One. Two. Three.
Yeah.